Well, it's the changing of the guard at the Minnesota State Capitol. Not only have the Democrats taken control of the Senate, but the leadership posts have changed in the last 2 hours. And we might see a bit of an experience gap when things get started next year as well, because there's 47 brand new House members and 23 new senators who won on Tuesday night. Here's John Croman.
The first time I left in the cupola, extensive
we saw a bumper crop of retirement speeches in the House last May as some very familiar faces headed for the door.
You are amazing, and you show up here every single day.
I guess I just figured out how to be around the right people.
And then you listen to all these speeches.
Over in the Senate, the same kind of tune as people with decades of legislative experience sang their swan song.
And we all come together. Different people from different places. And thank you for the memories that I will cherish forever.
When it was all said and done, 19 senators left politics altogether. One decided to run for the House. Three ran for other offices. 23 total retired. In the House, 20 left politics. 11 left the House to run for the Senate, and 5 ran for other offices for a total of 36 empty seats. Add to that 8 incumbent House members and 1 incumbent senator who were involuntarily retired by the voters on Tuesday. That translates to a lot of lawmaking expertise just going away.
Behind these closed doors is what they call the Senate DFL caucus meeting. It's where all 34 senators, people are going to be senators in 2023 session, met to pick their leaders. There was a lot of speculation over who would get it. Some thought probably Aaron Murphy, but it turned out to be somebody else completely.
When the Senate Democrats emerged from their secret session, we learned they had elected Carrie Diedzic of Minneapolis, a 10-year veteran of the Senate, as the new Senate Majority Leader.
Voters told us they don't want gridlock. They gave us a trifecta. And so my role is to keep us unified together and to move stuff forward to improve Minnesotans' lives.
Bobby Joe Champion, another Minneapolis senator, will hold the gavel as president. He'll preside over Senate sessions.
And even though I have the skills and qualifications, it was not lost on me that Minnesota has never had a Senate president of color.
Senate Republicans picked their new leader today as well. Mark Johnson of East Grand Forks is the new Senate Minority Leader.
I think one of our biggest things is ensuring that we're talking to Minnesotans, making sure that we're having those communications to know what their priorities and needs are. And then we can go to those events where we're taking votes on the floor or in committee and being able to say, hey, here's what Minnesotans are telling us.
So far, no indication of whether or not the Senate will change the old rule. The senators aren't allowed to look at each other while they're debating.
That's kind of an obscure question, but I don't foresee it.
In St. Paul, John Croman, Care 11 News.
To bury the lead, they can't look at each other when they're debating? I've never, in 20 years, I've never heard that.